thought I'd show you how things are coming along. We got pretty much everything, like boxes and stuff, out of the living room. Just that. Laundry, but that's gonna happen. You got lunch! Ooh. It's just the back to nature mac and cheese. He loves it. It's like the all natural mac and cheese. So we need to put another curtain out. My husband's not too sure about those curtains. We might end up changing them out, and I might put those ones in here because this was gonna be the office slash my husband's music room, but it's just too small. So put the light on. It's gonna become kind of a playroom for him, so that way his toys are out in the living room. So there's gonna be like a couple, like those two have toys in it. And so it's gonna be a playroom slash learning room for him. But also I'm gonna put a small little desk here. And eventually I'll have like a little computer so I can edit and stuff here. And this will be kind of like a school room slash slightly kind of playroom for him, and editing filming room for me. So I wouldn't mind if those were in here if he ends up not wanting them out there. So that will be kind of neat. So that's what we have for there. This is the living room again. You put some stuff on the mantle. Got all our books and movies in that little cubby. The TV is not going to always be there. We had to use that temporarily because our other one broke. The entryway is coming along. It's not 100% of what we want. Nothing is, really. But that's like the summer room. So we have this coat rack here. And then, oops, getting foggy. It's getting foggy. And then this is it's just a little tin thing up there. Yeah. We put coats and stuff in there, but we also have this closet here that we can put stuff in, like shoes and coats and bags. That's the front door. This floor is going to be painted eventually, because having it white is just not good with shoes. Froggy's in here, buddy. So let me shut the light off. And then, let me come back into the living room. That's going to be an island, but we just use it for a little table for him now. And then this is the kitchen. So slowly getting there with stuff. We're not sure if that's going to stay there. The island's going to be here that he's going to build, and then the rack will go like over there or something. This is an old like pantry thing, so we have food and stuff in there. And this is kind of neat. We put like teas and coffee and medicine, so it's out of reach of Riker, and some drinking glasses and things. And then we have fruit and veggies there, pots and pan rack, which is convenient. So that's how that is. And then I'll quickly put you guys in here. This is pretty much Riker's bathroom and guest bathroom to use the potty and whatnot, but this is his tub. And I put that back just to make it look kind of nice. And then his little rack of all his little bath stuff. Eventually I do want that hung up, but we're going to paint in here eventually. Because as you can see, even the windowsill like needs it badly. So, but yeah. Oh yeah, and then we have like this little hutch behind the toilet, which is kind of cute. Very cottage-like, I don't know, reminds me of. And then as far as here, we haven't done much. We still need to put curtains up. And then we have boxes here that need to be put away, like here and in the cupboard and things like that. So slowly getting there, but there's still some things here and there where I'm like, do we really need this? We have a bigger area, but I'm just like looking at some stuff that we have, and I'm just like, I'm ready to get rid of even more stuff that we've already gotten rid of. It's a good thing about moving is you end up wanting to get rid of things, which is good. So I might end up giving away some more things, I'm not sure, and if not, then we'll always find a place for it. We need furniture really bad. We need stands for the living room, we need another chair for the living room, we need a TV, which is not furniture, but we need a TV so bad, and we need two nightstands, two barrows, one for Riker, one for us, and a desk for me, a small desk for me, and I think that's it. Any little shelving, like toy organizing stuff we need to get. So we're looking a lot on like Craigslist, and if anyone offers like free stuff, you know, we're willing to take that. So it's just a lot of like things we're looking for that we need for this place. So, but it's coming together, and I am excited about, you know, getting it together, because this house does have a lot of character and kind of neat look to it. So feels a lot more like a home, I guess. Not saying I didn't, the trailer didn't feel like a home. It did feel like a home. It, you know, we're there for almost 3 years, but it's just, this place kind of feels more home because I guess it is a house, so it just feels more structured and like we could actually make a little home here. But we'll see how long we can stay, huh? You watching Shrek? With the VCR, so we're going totally back to 1990s when I was a kid, when we had the old school TV, a VCR, and VHS tapes. That's what we've been watching lately. Gets him to see what me and Daddy used to do when we were kids. Right, buddy? So we're about to head to... Actually, I shouldn't film that. Let's see what I can film. So we're about to head to the store again to go food shopping, and my hair keeps falling out. I should just leave it, but it's kind of a rainy day, which is a good thing because that means it's not cold enough to snow.
Mama.
It's been pretty warm, so I'm excited.
Mama.
What?
Mama.
We're gonna go. So we're gonna go shopping, and I don't think we're doing too much after that, but see what I can get. So as usual, I forgot to film in there, but he got a little yaoi thing as usual, and I couldn't resist. He's obsessed with Toy Story, and they had Buzz Lightyear for pretty much half off, so I couldn't help it, and I had to get him one, because he loves that stuff. And then I got some cat litter, some diapers. Usually I get the huge pack, but I just got the small pack for now, and then I got, we show this really quick, buddy, and then we'll go for shopping. And then I got just a couple little things of clothes because they're only a dollar for him. Just two shirts and pants. And then I really needed this so bad for my hair and my nails and stuff, but and my skin. But I figured I would just get it. It was only a little over $7. And then I got this because this stuff is amazing. If you're really dry, you can use it on your face, your body. It's good for your feet. And then this I needed for my hair because, I don't know if I mentioned it, but my hair is so extremely damaged right now from the dry winter that it's like breaking. So I got this stuff to try out. I heard really good things about it. So we're going to open Buzz and then we're going to head to shopping, huh?
I caught in there.
Yeah. Open
let's
up.
Eat it.
Let's go into the store.
No, I want chocolate.
You want the chocolate? You want to bring the chocolate with you? All right, let's leave the stuff in here. Careful. You want to leave Birdie in here? Let's stick him in. Say hi. your diaper's icky. Good morning, guys. So I haven't been filming for a while just because I know that I have a lot of stuff to get caught up on with videos. I just haven't been in a creative mood lately, and I think it's just because I'm really trying to settle into this place and make it look nice before I really like film a lot. And I know I shouldn't. He's gonna show you guys his toy. Yes, show him that.
This.
Yeah, are you excited that you got Buzz? Andy's watching Buzz on there. As we have our two TVs, because as you can see, that one's broken, and then we're using this one for VHSs just for now until we are able to get a different TV eventually. So things have been kind of still kind of crazy, I don't know, up in the air here and there, just because like we're trying really hard to get proper furniture for this place. We still don't have a bed frame. The mattress we're not sure if we're gonna keep because it was an older mattress from somebody else, and so we're not sure if we actually, of our 6 years of marriage, want to actually get a brand new mattress for the first time, because our last one was used, not like they didn't use it a lot, but it was used enough, so we're not sure what we want to do as far as that. And then we need nightstands, we need side tables for the living room, we need at least another chair or two in the living room. We need more rugs and bureaus. We need at least two. If we can't find like a good proper one for me and him to share, then we're gonna have to buy like two small ones for us and then one for Riker. We've been looking on Craigslist, we've been looking on so many places just so we don't have to like spend the full amount of money on, you know, each item, because that can add up, especially with furniture. So it's just crazy when you need like every little thing or every type of little furniture, so it's kind of frustrating. But that's how things have been lately, just trying to like get settled and figure things out with this place and get it cleaned and everything. So But I wanted to film a little today because we haven't lately, and there are some videos that I've been thinking about doing and I really want to work on, but it's just the matter of trying to get things situated. So timing is just, you know, everything right now. I'm trying to figure things out, but I thought I'd show you what it looks like outside because it's actually kind of pretty, even though I'm really tired of snow. This is what our backyard looks like right now. So excuse the cobwebs on these old windows, but hey, it's an old 1830s house or a little cottage, so there's gonna be stuff like that. But that's what the backyard looks like right now, out my kitchen window. As you can see way back there, right there, there's a little stream. So that's gonna be nice to take Riker to. Just a little stream there. But that's another thing too, it's kind of awkward filming because I don't wanna obviously share exactly where I live because that's dangerous. So I just try to find angles, make sure I don't film a certain window or anything that would give off like where I would live. So that's been kind of like interesting of what to do. So, and then the fact that things aren't set. I mean, I know things aren't gonna be perfect no matter what, but it's just like when things are still kind of chaotic, it's kind of hard to film. This crib is there by the window. I did put his little twinkle lights up, but I think I'm going to put more on this side because there's like another area. But we want to film in here. I mean film. We want to paint in here as well eventually. Hopefully. We'll see how that goes. But I put his toys there. I did have a little area with all his like old boppy pillows and stuff. I had him sitting there so we could like sit there and read. I have his books and stuff because I don't have a bookshelf quite yet for him. So I had a little area there. But of course, having a toddler, it gets messed up. So, but yeah, that's the only room that's kind of like, I don't know, it's still kind of crazy. I don't know what I'm talking about. It's all right. Things will be together in time.
I gotta go, huh?
Oh, there you go. You want to tell them which ones? Which
one's
which?
I have.
Right here.
Here.
Right here. Which one's this?
Here.
You gotta point further, like this. See? Do you tell them what that one is?
King.
Who's that?
Steve. And Mina.
Say that one again. Who's that?
Mina.
Who's this?
This is Doc. And what's this?
Okay, set him right here and tell him who it is.
Yeah.
Who is that?
Daddy King.
Okay, who's this? Come on, sit back. Oop. Who's this?
Dido. And this one car. This is green car. Green car.
This is a green car. Who's this?
This is Star, and what's this? This is Luigi.
Okay, so sit right here and say Luigi.
Yeah.
Say it. Who's this? This one. Who's this?
Luigi.
All the sand. If you play with it, you have to make sure you do not make tons of messes.
Yeah.
Okay. Can you play on the table?
Okay.
And not make messes? So I picked up in here. He's getting ready to go to sleep. I have those clothes. Our washer and dryer is down in the basement, so I always pile them there and then bring them down. Another thing that we really would like to do as far as decorating is to find pieces, like even our furniture that we find, to make it complement the place, because the place was built in like 1830s or 1850s or whatnot, so it has that like very period piece style to it, that like, you know, English cabin or English cottage look. So we really would like to add to it because it's something we've always been passionate about, is that time era or around that time. I like the 1700s and 1800s and some of the 1900s. I know I was born in the 1900s, but it just seems, I don't know, weird to say like all of it, because not all of it was like something I really like as far as the clothing, the style of their house, you know, mostly English, some French and whatnot, and Italian stuff that I do like their layouts of their houses and whatnot, but like the cottage stuff I always really like. I always find their style really like comforting and cozy and elegant. They just really know how to put it all together and make it look really nice, with also adding that kind of like cozy aspect of it, with like the fireplace and whatnot. So it always made me wish that I could have a place like that. Although this place is still pretty run down, there's a lot of things that we could fix up, adding more paint and then adding the furniture pieces we might find. We're working really hard to find furniture pieces that aren't too expensive but also have that kind of like character that we kind of want for the place. So we'll see what we can find, but it just kind of is nice to be able to live in a place that we've kind of always wanted to live in, even though it's a rundown house. It's just something we always liked, that kind of older style, you know, kind of look. So decided to make some chop suey. I don't even know what I'm making. Maybe I should check before I start cutting more ingredients. I am making beef stew because it is snowy, and beef stew is always good when it's snowy and cold and you want something kind of yummy, right? So I got the beef in there browning up, getting all nice and yummy while this guy plays with his toys. I also had some beef that needed to be eaten up. It was a big roast, a butt, a tuck butt, I don't know. So I needed to eat it up, so I'm just browning it up and then gonna let it cook for a couple hours. Alright, I'm gonna find you. Oh, is he in this basket? No? Oh, is he? There he is! Ah! Let's run in this dark room! Oh no! Okay, Mama, hide now, okay? Ready? Where can I hide? Ah! Okay, you gotta count. Count and I'll hide. Okay? You're so silly. Hold on, Mom needs to check on the beef stew. Whew. So I made some biscuits that are in the oven. And check on this beef stew. Ha ha hot. Hot hot cover. So might need to be thickened up a little more. Yeah, it does. I'm gonna thicken it up and check the taste. So they're a bit thin, but some more biscuits. So they should taste okay. They're seeming like nice and fluffy and flaky, so that one looks kind of cool. But yeah, this is the biscuits, and this is the roast beef. Well, technically, beef stew. Hey, give me that. You can't have that. You need to have dinner.